Hey guys, it's your buddy Rob Molina back at it again with another episode. And in this episode, I'm just going to discuss a couple of things that I've been lucky enough to have received from friends and things that, you know, that I enjoy that aren't related to Funko or Funko Pops, which of course I do love, I do enjoy. I mean, a million of you guys enjoy the same thing, but I'm guessing as collectors, we sort of, you know, try to collect things, you know, outside of, you know, whatever fandom we collect and whatever, you know, series or whatever movie or TV show we enjoy. We also like to sort of, you know, dibble and dabble in other things. So, you know, I'm just like one of you guys, but we'll get to it. Of course, as a young kid, you know, I was a humongous geek, humongous nerd, gawky, weird, goofy. And when I watched this show as a young kid, I was just able to relate to it in some way. But the show being Star Trek: The Next Generation. And of course, the character or the figure in the box is Lieutenant Commander Data, who's portrayed by the actor Brent Spiner. This show was a show that I watched from beginning to end. I think it was a show that I may have watched every single episode at least 3 to 4 times. I mean, I couldn't get enough of this show. I was, you know, in love with every single one of the characters. I loved the fact that they were able to explore space and, you know, visit new worlds and sort of, you know, do the things that maybe I wanted to do as a young kid, or the things that I aspired to be as a young kid. I guess as a young boy or girl, I mean, who doesn't have aspirations of, you know, someday, you know, flying in a rocket ship and, you know, traveling to the moon and traveling to Mars? So, you know, I'm guessing, you know, this show in some way, like, sort of like fulfilled that fantasy, fulfilled that dream. I filled that spark inside of me. So, this guy, Lieutenant Dana, you know, was definitely the best character, in my opinion, as far as the show goes. I was actually lucky enough to have, you know, met the actor, Brent Spiner, at a local Comic-Con, at the Rhode Island Comic-Con, 2 years ago. And I was definitely starstruck, definitely acting like a little schoolgirl, you know. I couldn't, like, bring myself to talk to the guy, you know, I was there with my buddy Poppin' Stories, Mike Funny, Mike J, and he sort of coaxed me and sort of convinced me to, you know, man up and go talk to the guy, and I'm glad he did. I'm glad I was able to go up to him and talk to him. What made it more special was the fact that Kylie was with me, and, you know, I guess Kylie got to see me, you know, act like a big idiot, you know, in front of one of my childhood, crushes, not crushes, but one of my childhood, you know, favorite actors. You know, this guy was, certainly very nice, very, hospitable, very cool. And, you know, he told us a couple of funny stories. So, yeah, I'm glad, you know, my buddy Mike was able to pick this up for me. And, yeah, I love this show, as you couldn't tell. I guess, you know, if we continue, then if we're talking about Data, we have to talk about Lieutenant Geordi LaForge, who was portrayed by the actor LeVar Burton, who is, I think, most famous for the TV series Reading Rainbow, which was a show on PBS, I believe, back in the day. And, you know, I guess the guy got acclaim for that. The guy became pretty famous for that show, and I'm guessing he just sort of ballooned in popularity after, you know, this show. You know, definitely, I think my second favorite character on the show, definitely Data first, Lieutenant Geordi LaForge would be second, and I'm guessing Jean-Luc Picard would have been third, who was the captain of the ship, who was portrayed by Patrick Stewart, who's also known as Dr. Xavier. and all the X-Men movies. But yeah, you know, I was so happy when I got these a couple years ago from my buddy Mike. You know, he definitely hooked me up. I was definitely, you know, taken aback by these things. You know, I love them, and I'm glad, you know, they're in my collection, and I'm glad that, you know, I have friends like Mike helping me out. So thank you, bud. Let's see. Oh, okay. Well, on the theme of Mike and him being a good friend and just being an overall great guy, wanted to show this off. This was also something else I picked up, or that he picked up at the Rhode Island Comic Con last year, in 2018. Of course, if you guys don't know who this guy is, this is Luffy, who's the captain of the Going Merry Pirates, and a part of the show One Piece, which is a humongous anime that's been around for quite some time. I believe it's the 20th anniversary this year, I believe, in October. It's possibly the 20-year anniversary, so, you know, big salute to, you know, the show. You know, this guy, his motto is to be the king of all pirates someday, and the show basically encompasses and, you know, talks about, you know, basically his adventures on that mission, and hopefully, you know, when the show does end someday, hopefully when the show, you know, has a climax and an end to it, that, you know, hopefully our friend over here, Luffy, reaches that milestone and he's able to fulfill his dream of being, you know, the king of all pirates. But, yeah, the cool thing about this was, you know, when you do go to these Comic-Cons, there's a bunch of artists that do show up. And, you know, it's just starving artists trying to make a name for themselves, you know, trying to sort of like become the next, you know, Stan Lee or the next Todd McFarlane, you know, this sort of just trying to become, you know, identifiable, you know, and they're trying to be, you know, known. And the cool thing about this was that, you know, it definitely was a print signed by one of the artist at the show, and you know, I love this pose that Luffy's in. Of course, he's getting ready to throw down, getting ready to kick somebody's ass, as you can see. Yeah, everything about this picture screams coolness. You know, I'm glad that my buddy Mike Funny, Poppin' Stories, Mike J, you know, you hooked me up once again. You know, I just haven't had an opportunity to show it off on my channel, but I just wanted to, you know, shout you out for just always being a great friend and always looking out for me, and, you know, that's what friends are for, right? Romance. And the last thing I'll pull out, the last thing I'll talk about is, once again, another artist did attend the Comic-Con, and he goes by the name of Tony Paulson, and he does have an Instagram page, and the Instagram page goes by the name of at TheTonus, so TheTonus. You know, I was, you know, walking with you know, some friends, walking with Mike Funny, Mike J, and Poppin' Stories, and we were sort of just kind of like, you know, just browsing every single nook and cranny of the Comic-Con, and when I walked upon this guy's stand, the Tonus, at the Tonus, or Tony Paulson, I was sort of gravitated to the artwork that I saw, and of course, me being a My Hero fan, and you know, I enjoy anything that's My Hero related. And of course, if you guys don't know, this is the man himself, basically the you know, the star of the show for at least the first couple of seasons, before he passes the baton to Deku. It's our buddy All Might, and yeah, I just, for whatever reason, I just enjoyed the artwork. It sort of like appealed to me. You know, it's definitely sort of cartoony, sort of like some of the airbrushed sort of artwork you might see at a local carnival or at a local fair. But to me, this just stuck out. It was just very cool, very, very well drawn. I love the fact that, you know, there's all this like empty space in the back, and then you kind of see this yellow gloved figure reaching through that black hole or that void in space. And to me, it looks like Thanos's glove, sort of like reaching out, grabbing All Might, and sort of like, you know, sticking him out of that hole and sort of like, you know, showing him off to the world. But yeah, this guy had a bunch of stuff posted on his back wall of his display area. And I mean, he had basically every fandom you could think of, from, you know, Marvel to DC to anime. As far as the anime, I think he only had like maybe, you know, All Might, Deku, might have had Todoroki, and Bakugo might have been the other My Hero characters that he had. I think I might have even asked him if he had a Stain display or Stain piece of artwork, which is a villain from My Hero that I totally love, and would totally love to have anything related to Stain, whether it's pop form or and, you know, displayed in art form would be awesome as well. But yeah, this guy is definitely talented, definitely someone I would sort of recommend hitting up. Yeah, I'm glad that I did pick this up when I did, and hopefully if Tony comes back to my Comic-Con next year, then I think I'm going to pick up at least one more, two more of these bad boys. And the guy was nice enough to have posted like a little message on the back. So of course he puts his little signature, Tony Paulson. It says Rhode Island 2018. And of course, you know, we have him writing the most like identifiable sort of two words in the show. In My Hero are plus 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 ultra. Yep. So yeah. You know, I'm glad I was able to, you know, gather these things and, you know, add them to my collection. So, hopefully you guys like them as well. And, I'll make this short but sweet, but hopefully you guys enjoy your day, and hopefully you keep on collecting what you like. All right, guys. Enjoy. Bye.